Hare Krishna. If we think humbly, we won't have to act dumbly. When we are, say, driving along a road and we come to an intersection and we don't know, should I go this way or that way? If at that time we have the humility to acknowledge that I don't know, then we can ask, find a reliable authority, and then move along the right path. But if we, in our thinking itself, are very arrogant, I know everything, why should I consult anyone? And if we think arrogantly, then we will end up acting stupidly. However, if we think humbly, oh, better let me confirm, I don't know, let me find out, then we will act intelligently, we'll be able to get to our destination. What applies to a journey by driving also applies to the journey of life itself. Frequently, we come across situations in our life where we can't be sure, should I do this or should I do that? And at that time, we need to turn towards something different from our own mind and intelligence. That is where scripture comes into the picture. And the teachers of scripture come into the picture. They help us go down to our deepest identity and our deepest values. And when we go down to that fundamental essence of who we are, then we can choose by drawing from that essence. This is what happens to Arjun in the Bhagavad Gita when he's confused. Not knowing what to do, he says to Krishna, I surrender to you. Karpanya doshopahata swabhava pruchhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetaha yashreyasyan nishchitam bruhi tanme shishyasteham shadimam tvam prapannam. So Krishna, please tell me, I surrender to you, I become your disciple. Please tell me, what is the right course of action? Dharma, I want to know what is my duty. So similarly for us, when different obligations and different situations and different desires pull us in various directions, if we turn towards Krishna and humbly seek guidance, then the wisdom coming from Krishna will help us to choose wisely. Thank you. Hare Krishna.